10,000 Syrian rebels are on the Pentagon's payroll. That revelation coming from a U.S. Defense Department budget request. Washington now hopes to increase that number to 65,000, despite the crushing failure of a previous train and equip program.
One key element of the DOD's strategy to defeat ISIS is to train, equip, sustain and enable elements of the vetted Syrian opposition. These forces are projected to total approximately 60 to 65,000.
65,000. This pet army would be bigger than the Canadian or Australian militaries. And don't forget, there are already three warring armies in Syria. The Pentagon is planning on equipping and providing this puppet force with everything but their underwear. Tens of thousands of new rifles, machine guns, mortars, millions of rounds of ammunition, 1,000 vehicles. And don't forget, they're seemingly going to pay their salaries, $200 to $400 a month. It's all in the new counterterrorism fund request. It says clearly, once ISIS is destroyed, this new army will stabilize and patrol the territory it holds, near enough a third of Syria, which meshes well with Washington's plans to stay in Syria indefinitely, keep the country split up and prevent Assad from winning. But there are questions like, where is the US going to find 30,000 more moderate rebels when it couldn't find 10?
Can you tell us what the total number of trained fighters remains?
It's a small number, and the ones that are in the fight is we're talking four or five.
The last time the US trained, equipped, and sent forth a rebel army, they all promptly gave up their guns and joined al-Qaeda. They spent hundreds of millions on that, by the way. It was really embarrassing. Anyway you look at it, this means more war. It says so in black and white. The US will only train and equip vetted Syrian opposition and hope that this time they don't all turn out to be Islamist radicals.
Well, in the document, the Pentagon says it will monitor the use of arms it supplies to the rebels wherever possible. However, experts we spoke to believe there are no guarantees the weapons won't end up in the hands of extremists.
Well, I think they want to create, and in fact, this is really what they have stated, is that they want to create conditions in Syria where the country is still divided. I mean, the record of the US and the CIA's operations in Syria is that, you know, the people they have supported all along have been extremists. This was the US goal all along, to militarize the conflict, to pour in foreign fighters and weapons across the Turkish border. And this was the US policy.
We don't know who these forces are. Clearly, some of them are going to be some of the forces, the opposition forces, which had been involved in the struggle against the Syrian government and its allies. But the forces which had been were trained by the United States were, in fact, proved to be ineffective. When they lost, they either abandoned their weapons, sometimes they decided to join the group or the forces that were fighting against them. Once you send weapons to a country that is facing civil war, you can no longer control those weapons, and that's a problem.